Good morning guys, let's see constructors in C++. As we know, class is a user defined data type and we want class to behave very similar to built-in data types. In the case of built-in data type, we have one concept, and that concept is initialization of variables. For example, if I write int a equals to 5, then in this case variable a is created and it is initialized with value 5. No dummy data, no random data, it is having one value, that is 5. Similarly, we want to initialize objects with some values. So for initializing objects of a class, we have constructors. Let's see constructor concept with an example. Suppose I am having one class caps A, curly bracket opening, curly bracket closing and a semicolon. In the private section, I have two variables in A, comma B. In public section, I am having one member function and its name is caps A, bracket, curly bracket opening, closing and in between A equals to 0, B equals to 0. So as you can see, the name of this member function and the name of this class is same. They both are same. So this is your constructor. First property of constructor is its name is same as your class name. Fine. Constructor is placed in public section of a class. Constructor never returns any value. Please remember, constructor never returns any value. So we will not have anything before your constructor name. Fine. So again repeating, constructor name is same as your class name. So if my class name is caps A, so my constructor name is caps A. Fine. Constructor is placed in public section. Constructor never returns any value. So before your constructor name, you will not have any return value, not even void. Fine. And let's see in main function, int main, curly bracket opening, curly bracket closing, return 0. This is for this int. Fine. Next, I am writing one statement, caps A, that means this class, A object. When you write this statement, one object, A object is created. And this object, please listen carefully, this object calls this member function automatically. That means when we are creating your object, constructor is invoked automatically. That means A and B both will be initialized with value 0. You are not explicitly calling, you are not using dot operator, you are not calling A. You are just creating an object, and when you create this object, this constructor is called automatically. This constructor is invoked automatically. When this constructor is invoked, next in the statement, as you can see, we are initializing A and B with values 0. So when your object A object is created, A and B variables, they both are created and initialized with value 0. So this is the concept of constructors. Constructors are used to initialize objects. Fine. Constructor name is same as your class name. Constructor never returns any value. It is placed in public section and it is invoked automatically. Fine. Thank you.